Hi, I'm Carlton Ray, director of the Clean Rivers Project, a $2.6 billion program that captures combined or raw sewage that's currently going into the Anacostia River, Potomac, and Rock Creek every time it rains. We're building a tunnel system that will divert the flow and convey that down to Blue Plains Wastewater Treatment Plant, the world's largest advanced wastewater treatment plant.
This project is a water pollution improvement project. What we're doing here is we're excavating a tunnel 2.5 miles long and 23 feet in diameter. And it's going to intercept sewer overflows, which are a combination of rainwater and sewer water that normally go into the river. Put those into this big pipe, which will go down to the water treatment plant.
Surface operations are a vital part of the process. Every day, up to 40 trucks with segments are delivered to the job site, together with other materials such as bentonite, cement, and other consumables. The material is then stored up in the surface and then lowered down in the tunnel and toward the tibia.
We have a lot of people who work here. We have approximately, at the peak, somewhere around 200 people working here. We have all kinds of people from all over the place. We have people from Italy working here. We have local people working on this project, labor, union, operators, and we're all working together for Washington, D.C. and for our owner, D.C. Water.
The muck remover from the job site is another very important part of the process. Every day, about 300 trucks are coming and going from the job site, removing up to 2,500 cubic yards of material. Logistics of material coming and going, together with the muck and all the consumables, is a key part of your operation. Right now we are excavating in a very thick clay. In order to be able to transport the material properly, we need to treat the material inside the excavation chamber. We inject water, foam, and polymer, mix it with the excavated material, and then condition it to the point where it's discharging the conveyor belt. You can see that the EVM and the conveyor belt are a combined system. It is continuously transporting the material out from the tunnel. Without the conveyor belt, you cannot do the excavation with the tibia. It's a continuous operation and it's a key component of the whole system. You can see the 50-ton gantry crane, which is transporting the material from the shaft pit all the way to the surface. The clamshell is a 16 cubic meter capacity clamshell and is capable to transport about 30-40 ton of material all the way to the surface. This is the heart of the machine. This is where all the material are received and controlled. One ring is offloaded in this area with the segment crane toward the feeder. The feeder is transporting the segment all the way to the TBM ring assembling area. The ring is built in about 25 minutes and is composed by 6 segments plus the key. There are longitudinal connecting dowels and radial bolts which are connecting the segment together. And the ring is designed for a durability of 100 years. You can also see the TBM operator in communication with the grouting operator. The grouting operator is controlling the backfill grout around the segment and in this area can communicate directly with the TBM operator. So now we are in the operator cabin. Basically, this is the brain of the machine. You can see all the parameters of the machine. You can see the speed, you can see the penetration rate, all the hydraulic system. You can see one of the main factors on the machine, which is the EPB pressure. Right now we are excavating at about 2 to 3 inches per minute. And the push is normally taking about 30 minutes. And then in 30 minutes, we are building the ring. One of the things you can see here is also the balance of the spoil. So it's important that we excavate and we keep under control the material. And then you have all the camera for the conveyor belt at the location of the tree boosters. The machine is on the right spot and it's very important to complete the excavation in the right position with the machine. We have very tight tolerances in terms of horizontal and vertical, and our operators are doing a good job with this.
We are almost done. With the tunnel, there's a few rings left, and try to do the best that we can do it and complete the tunnel for this project.
We have about 116 feet to complete the excavation of the tunnel, and the crew is very excited about this.
Once we finish the tunnel system, we will capture 98% of combined sewage or raw sewage that's currently going to the river on an annual basis. That's amazing capture. And today we're at the terminus of the Anacostia River Tunnel, the 12,500-foot tunnel that's part of our overall 13-mile tunnel that convey the sewage to Blue Plains. We're excited to have Cellini Infagillo and Parsons joint venture team to successfully complete the project along with DC Water and the Clean Rivers Program. That partnership has allowed us to be on schedule and on budget, and we're excited for that to occur.